Good afternoon. We were your ninth grade teachers, and we never actually got to say goodbye to you. You went from being real people to these tiny little boxes on the screen. We had you for about 3/4 of the year, and then many of you disappeared behind screens and blobs and...
I got given a little bit of extra time because I feel like I'm addressing both the seniors and the juniors. I know some of them are here. So the question that I want to address is, bear with me. This is going to be the shortest argument ever, with LOR and everything. Okay. Who am I? This is arguably the most pondered question in human history. Agreed, probably not so much nowadays, because who has time to contemplate things, right?
We will be your MCs for the rest of the night.
As we gather to celebrate our hard work of 6 years of dedication and passion.
Don't forget risk-taking and initiative.
And all the rest of the core values that we all know so well. As we stand here today, undeniably bonded by our experiences and growth as a cohort.
Some might say it was time well spent. And others, well, I'm sure everyone had a good time.
To reflect on all our memories we have made, we're going to be welcoming Rita Fellows, one of our valedictorian.
And one of our salutatorians, Ethan Chang, to the stage.
Today is a very bittersweet day for some, being the last time we're all gathered here together as a cohort.
For some, it might just be sweet.
These past 6 years have been a true roller coaster ride, but through the memories we've made, we've come to know all whopping 39 of us very well.
From Miss Shillingo's soda rockets to Mrs. Miller Moody's quest, we've seen it all. And I still remember how we got snacks only in seventh grade. I wonder what happened to them. And I also remember Patrick Maurer's activities, where us, the STEM leaders, would practice collaborative spirit and team building.
I remember grinding late nights for FTC and waking up the next morning ready to show off my gracious professionalism. I remember when we first stepped foot into high school, it felt like we were just beginning to adjust, and then COVID hit.
The Screencastify app used to create those magnificent, brief but spectacular videos, always crashed and recorded low-quality videos.
Regardless, I personally enjoyed making bread for extended hours.
And I also enjoyed Mr. Tan's problematic webcam. Whether it was upside down, sideways, zoom to out, or all of the above.
And of course, we can't forget how STEM has engraved in our minds their 9 core values. Let's start with risk-taking. I mean, coming into high school, I would never have dared to start memorizing my entire IMP the night before I presented, but here I am now.
Let's also not forget how we got to show our creativity and initiative while planning for the hallway beautification project.
Things didn't exactly work out the way we thought they would, and eventually we ended up plastering directional signs to the wall, but we learned the importance of adaptability in the process. Might have to make it the 10th core value.
And whether we were practicing determination while cramming research paper drafts in big R research, or engaging in communication during empathy interviews, we've grown so much in every value, as demonstrated by the thorough performance reviews everyone enjoys writing.
All jokes aside, our cohort has left a very strong legacy. Through our multiple FTC, FLL, Project Invent, and Explorer Vision achievements, not to mention the countless Science Fair awards our projects have received. And I'll definitely miss having the ability to CAD, CAM, and create at any given moment. I mean, how many schools can say they have their own fab lab?
All in all, the STEM program has changed so much, with us seeing 3 different directors in the span of just 6 years. But we too have changed a lot.
We've gained so much knowledge, opportunities, and experience in the fields that we wish to pursue, and acquired other soft skills that will stay with us long into the future.
And unlike how things were when we came in as teeny midget middle schoolers, things are about to get real. Just like how Miss Toyama has repeatedly warned us of, in the work world, no one's going to hold our hands.
And as Miss Sakara always reminds us, there will be times when we feel like going for the lowest hanging fruit, like we're bringing the nutmeg to the table, but in our own ways, every one of us is part of that apple pie.
With that being said, congratulations to us seminarians and researchers for surviving these tumultuous 6 years. And we wish you best of luck in your future endeavors.
Thank you.
We are most likely to shop in class, credit card on file and everything. So anytime you're in class, you can bet if you glance over at Alyssa and Sydney, they're upgrading their wardrobe for the next year. For Sydney, she also splits her screen so she can play 2048, just to add to the fun. Hey, come on. No, Alyssa. We got Sydney. Jimmy Fallon. The award for most likely to host a talk show goes to Boz and Brian.
Berkeley Regents herself, Narathi. And Sahana. Sahana, your million word long research paper proved you the best fit for this award.
to be the next CEOs. This year's cohort also produced two of the future Forbes top 100 companies. First off, we have Rita, who is our little Miss Valedictorian and our algorithmic bias genius, and Josh, who has worked tirelessly the past couple of years helping improve water quality. For our eighth award, we have the ones who are most likely to finish their homework while the teacher is collecting it. So our winners are the two people with the biggest reflexes, Ayush and Ayn. Even if you guys wouldn't touch the homework before the class period started, you would still have it on time.
This next award goes to those who have shown potential in the world of acting and theater. Hopefully they can act happy when they receive this award. The award for most likely to get an Oscar goes to Ethan and Katie! This next award is the most prestigious award. It goes to those who reflect the core values of determination, perseverance, and risk-taking. The people who receive this award have the skills to survive on their own and the determination to do so. The award for most likely to survive a zombie apocalypse goes to Daniel and Xavier! Giggle all night already backstage. So, next up, we're going to have
Ethan and Ayush to announce the final set of Student STEMI Awards.
Alright, so, for the next award category of most likely to become a pro athlete, we have Maisha Thomas, a she aces every volleyball game, and Giselle Mercado, make sure to don't get on the backside because she will tackle you.
And next, for the people who are most likely to invest in stocks or crypto, we have, of course, Suparn Posina, as he is always active on his computer, whether it be outside of school or even in class. We also have Rayon, who is undoubtedly CapCut's number one investor. We have Best in Upcoming Artist. Now, me and Ethan may disagree with our first winner, but we have Hemant Dinesh, aka Sarah Aaron Aaron Rin Rin Rin, who apparently has a talk on it. And of course, we can't forget KSK MUZ Kaushik Seymour. His YouTube videos have given the whole cohort great study music to listen to, so make sure you smash that subscribe button. Lastly, we have Lil Ari on the beat. Ario! Sometimes sacrifices must be made for scientific progress. And this award goes to the teacher who is most likely to put a hole in the classroom ceiling in the name of scientific discovery. Of course, this award goes to Ms. Shalingo. It took the whole year to replace that ceiling tile.
Next up, we have a staff member who is a master at drawing patterns for stress relief. The most likely to cover her class with Zentangles goes to Ms. Spector.
Salary into chocolates. As a result of mismatched student names, most likely to ransack a Costco for their supply of Toblerone chocolates, goes to our one and only Mr. Sane. Vocabulary goes to our one and only Ms. Sankara.
Oh, Evaporation is a huge word. So let's practice saying it together. Evaporation.
Woo! Alright, and today I'll be talking about the cell cycle and a detailed description of its phases.
No!